How to create a binary to BCD converter in Verilog HDL. My name is Grady, I'm with Simply Embedded, and today I'm going to show you how you can do that. So let's get started. All right, everyone. So today we're going to talk about binary to BCD conversion. So we're going to take this binary value, 213 in decimal, and convert it over to binary coded decimal, which stands for BCD. And it simply means that we're taking this 213 and breaking it down into hundreds, tens, and ones. So we're going to split the value 213 into 2, 1, and 3. So how do we do this? We're going to use an algorithm. I think it's better to see an example of this algorithm in action. So let's go through this example that I've prepared for you guys. So we have this table of this 8-bit value in binary that we're trying to convert over, which is 213. So this value here represents the value of 213. We have put this value into a bigger register called shift register from 19 through 0. So this one represents all the bits. So it's in this big register, 20-bit wide register. Let's go through the notations first. So the finish stands for that it's the end of the iteration. And the start means that it's about in the beginning of the iteration or somewhere around that. So what we're checking is any of the hundreds, tens, or ones greater or equal to 5 in the beginning of the iteration? If it is, add 3 and shift left. Shift left will be the last action that we'll be doing in the end of the iteration. No, don't do anything, but still shift left. So the first iteration we're doing is we're putting the 8-bit value 213 into the shift register. In the beginning of the iteration, ones, tens, and hundreds are all zeros, so we don't do anything but we shift left. Same case for the next one, we shift left. No, again, we shift left. Now, in the beginning of the iteration 4, we have this value here, which is 6. So ones is greater or equal to 5, which means that we can add 3 to it. So if we add 3 to it, we get 9. So 1001. And then we shift left in the end of the iteration. So now in the beginning of iteration 5, there's nothing going on. We just shift left again. So for the 6th iteration, 1s is greater or equal to 5. So we add 3, shift left. In the beginning of iteration 7, 10s are equal to 5. So we add 3 and shift left. So beginning of the last iteration, 1s are equal to 6. Which means that we add 3 and shift left. After that, we have our final value, which is 213. And that's how we do it. So let's move on to the Verilog code and let's see how it actually works in a simulation file. All right, everyone, so let's get started. Create a new project for binary to BCD, and we're gonna do this whole project in Verilog HDL. So first, you will need an input clock, a 8-bit value that's coming into the system, and 3 output values that are ones, tens, and hundreds. We are going to create a register I, which is used to keep track of the number of iterations in our code. Then a 20-bit wide shift register, and we will use it to complete the computations based on our algorithm that we discussed earlier. We also need 3 temporary registers for ones, tens, and hundreds. These are there to keep the actual output values of ones, tens, and hundreds unchanged until the final BCD value is ready. Then we'll have a register, old 8-bit value, that is used to store the input of the current 8-bit value until the value changes. This way, we can make our code go through the binary to BCD conversion only once. So initially, I created this system using a for loop, but for some reason, the for loop wasn't working. I was getting a bunch of errors and I decided to drop that idea. And I just rearranged the code so that instead of having a for loop, we're not having the whole system running on the positive edge of the clock. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna set up 3 if statements when I equals to 0, if I is less than 9, and if I is greater than 0, and the last one will be if I is equal to 9. So essentially we're running a loop that if I is equal to 0, we're gonna initialize all of our statements, and if I is less than 9 and greater than 0, we're gonna be running through the loop and doing the computations that we talked about earlier. If it reaches 9, we're going to make sure that I is equal to 0 again. So essentially, it's a for loop that runs on the clock. So this is a shift register that we initialize at 0 first. Now we're just saying that if the input at 8-bit value changes, we will run the loop again. Otherwise, we will not do that. If the old 8-bit value is equal to the new 8-bit value, we can say that the bottom 8 bits of the shift register are equal to the 8-bit value. So we're loading the input value off the binary value that we're trying to transfer over to the BCD value. Then we can say that the hundreds are equal to the top 4 bits of the shift register. And then we can initialize tens and ones that are also 4 bits each in the shift register. And then we can say that I is equal to I plus 1. So in the next if statement, we can actually set up the formula that we're using to transfer over from binary to BCD. So we can do this for hundreds, tens, and ones. Every time after we've checked if hundreds or tens and ones are greater than 5, we put them into a shift register using concatenation. Then we can shift the shift register left by 1 bit. And now we can set values to hundreds, tens, and ones again. And then we can repeat the same if statement until I is equal to 9. Technically, we wouldn't need the outputs for hundreds, tens, and ones. We could just set up everything using the shift register. Because of how we're doing and how it's set up, I just wanted to make sure that everything's clear, that these are hundreds, these are tens, and these are ones. So that's why I'm using more notations as necessary. You can make the whole code more condensed if you want to, but it's up to you. When I equals to 9, we can say the temporary register values of ones, tens, and hundreds are assigned to the actual output values of the ones, tens, and hundreds. Other than that, we can create a simulation now and test out our code and see if it works. All the inputs will turn into registers, output will turn into wires. Set up the unit under test and the clock signal. Put some values for the 8-bit values, whatever you want. You don't have to do actually 10, 248, and 139. Then launch the simulation. You can go ahead and under the scope select UUT, and then from the objects, drag in I shift register and old 8-bit value. This way, we can actually see what the internal registers are doing while we run the code. Reset the whole system and then run again. The 8-bit value is 0. We have 0, 0, 0. If it's 10, we have hundreds as 0, tens as 1. And if it's 248, we have hundreds 2, tens 4, and ones 8. The last one, which is 139, hundreds 1, tens 3, and ones 9. Thank you so much, guys, for checking out this video. I truly appreciate it. If you're new to this YouTube channel, consider subscribing and hit that like button if this video was helpful for you. Other than that, keep up the good work, and I'll see you next time.